folks. It's Rick Husey. I'm here with my friend Carlos Bustamante, the VP of Strategic Technologies here at Zecorum, and we're continuing on our stream series, Tech Tuesday, on proactive network maintenance. And today we're going to be talking about something called TDR, which you may be familiar with as a piece of physical equipment, but we're going to be talking more about how it relates to DOCSIS proactive network maintenance. So you want to take it from there?
Absolutely. So TDR, time domain reflectometry, in general, and many of you already know this, so TDR is an appliance that when connected to a test piece of cable, what it'll do is it will send a pulse down your test cable, and if it encounters an impedance mismatch, as we learned in a previous episode, there will be a bounce back. When that bounce back happens, essentially the time domain reflectometer, or the appliance, is measuring the time difference between the time it released the initial incident wave and the response it got back. So essentially it's doing that. And why does it do that? Again, the idea is you'll be able to get ascertain the cable length and be able to see where there are faults, because typically the fault is where the impedance mismatch happened. As far as the how does it calculate the timing, again, it goes back to something we talked about in a previous episode,
more
which
math.
Is exactly. So again, it's taking the D equals RT, or distance equals race times time, in which case the rate is the velocity of propagation, and as well as the time being the difference between the incident wave and the return wave to calculate the length of the piece of cable. So that's, in general, what's a TDR.
But and that's a disruptive test when you're using that piece of equipment.
Good point. Yeah. That's a very good point. So in that case, you are connecting this piece of cable to this appliance, this device, to be able to get these type of measurements. Mm-hmm. But let's talk about this more in the context of PNM. Mm-hmm. So the idea is the following. Much like we spoke about in the past, that because of the pre-equalization data that we get from all your DOCSIS cable modems, we're able to calculate information about the echo cavity, which is, again, the length of the piece of cable. You don't have to actually do a disruptive type test by disconnecting a customer, connecting an appliance, because you have hundreds or thousands of test points via your DOCSIS cable modems. So you essentially have TDRs in the plant collecting them throughout the day. So a little bit about the response wave after the pulse hits its first impedance mismatch. If the response hits an impedance mismatch that is high, well, in this case, we're saying above 75 ohms because that's what we expect in a coaxial network. The idea is that you're probably in an open situation. The response wave is going to be in phase, whereas if it's below the optimal 75 ohms is probably going to be in an open circuit type situation where you're going to get something that's 180 degrees out of phase. So what you see here, this representation in the upper right, is the wave is reflecting back in the same way, whereas in the bottom side, as we said, it's essentially inverted. It's 180 degrees out of phase. So in a short situation, it's more of smashed cabling, buried cables, dings and dents, open situation, probably missing terminators, that type of thing.
Got it. So in a PNM application, then, this is really what you're basically calculating the echo cavity, is that right?
Right. So what you're trying to do is ascertain the actual length of the cable segment or cable segments of which that cable, that echo cavity exists. Mm-hmm. So this goes back into our conversation of each contributing elevated digital tap. It's, of course, the channel bandwidth of the upstream port that was configured also plays into the math, as well as those taps that are elevated contribute, and you sum these together, and then you find the approximate echo cavity length.
Mm-hmm. Now, we are using the term TDR, which we're familiar with, but also vTDR, and that is, I guess, coming from our application, but it may not be, that language may not be used in every PNM application.
Right, so in general, this is TDR. The way we use it in our particular PNM application, is that when we're labeling them TDR, we're looking at shorter strands of cable, which are typically associated with near-home, in-home type issues, where if you're seeing, where as we label them vTDR, are longer, these are more longer strands of segments of cable that are attributed to more deeper in the outside plant.
So a lot of times you'll see a TDR of 65 feet or 85 feet, something like that, whereas your vTDR may be 600 feet, 800 feet.
That's right.
So you're looking at a micro reflection between a much longer point, which is much less likely to be an in-home issue, right?
So correct.
Or even a near-home issue.
That's right. Yeah. That's exactly right. Yeah. But yeah, so that is more on TDR, is that what it is, mm-hmm. how it works, and how it is used within the context of a PNM application.
Okay, good. So next week, we're going to, I think, close things up with looking at maybe a reactive approach and a proactive approach, because that's really what PNM is. It's a proactive approach. And you can have a tool that's very good for reactive kinds of things that may look just fantastic, and you still may have problems out there that could be fixed proactively.
Right. So up until this time, we've gone through, I think, five or six episodes that have building blocks of PNM, concepts, definitions, etc. Now we want to put it all together. So I definitely think it's interesting. So typically you have platforms that are more corrective diagnostics, reactive diagnostics, where you're collecting the traditional type of metrics of SNR, TX, RX of your modems, of or what you see in the interfaces. And everything in that platform looks green. So why is it that in my PNM app, we're looking at the same customer, mm-hmm. and yet we have some metrics that show in the red. Mm-hmm. So I think it's an interesting exercise to be able to compare one particular end customer from the corrective platform point of view, and then the same customer from our proactive network maintenance platform point of view, and see what the differences are, and maybe have some strategies on troubleshooting one particular customer.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because you're going to use the two tools together. They work very well together, but they have a different purpose.
They're very complementary. Yeah. Absolutely.
Yeah. Okay, great. Thanks a lot, Carlos. And again, we'll see you next week, folks. Bye.
Thank you.